Welcome to New Possibilities. I speak truth to power without fear. So you all remember a while ago, I did a video about a white man who killed a black man in Clearwater, Florida, over some parking space. So this white guy was arguing with a black woman about this parking space, about her using a certain parking space. And he's confrontational. He's confronting this woman. You know, the woman's boyfriend, whose name is Marcus McGlockton, stepped up and he defended his woman. And he pushed this guy. And after he pushed the guy down, he proceeded to try to walk away. And this guy pulled out a gun and shot and killed Marcus McGlockton. And that's the brother's name who was defending his sister. Shot and killed this brother. You know, so you had this older white man who shoots and kills this young black man. And this white man, for a while, he didn't face any charges. You know, the police were kind of reluctant to bring charges against this guy. And once charges were brought against him, he tried to raise the stand your ground defense. Fortunately, this man was convicted of manslaughter, and he was sentenced to 20 years in jail. And at the sentencing, the brother Marcus McGlockton's parents made statements in the court. And basically the father was talking about how you need to forgive in order to go to heaven. And, you know, that's part of being a good Christian or whatever. And the brother said, well, at this point, I'm not prepared to forgive. And then McLaughlin's mother actually issued an even stronger statement. She said that she would never forgive this guy for killing her son. And I don't blame her. I understand. I understand why the family is not willing to forgive, because too often you have these people who have been brainwashed into believing that it's godlike to love your enemies, it's godlike to forgive your enemies. Often these people forgive killers before these killers have even repented for anything, before these killers have even expressed any kind of remorse, before these killers have actually been sentenced. You have some of these brainwashed Negroes who are quick to forgive and quick to love people who have killed their loved ones. And you all know what happened with that Botham John case. You had the woman who killed him sentenced for 10 years, which was a slap on the wrist. And you had, you know, one of the brother, Botham John's, brothers actually come out and say, well, I forgive this woman. I love this woman. I don't want her to go to jail. You know, and it's just refreshing to see that you don't have, you know, this same kind of slave mentality here in this particular case. You have people that are actually real people that are saying what real people would actually say. You know, the average person who's just suffered a major tragedy, you know, losing a loved one, is not going to get up there talking about they love the person that killed their loved one. They're not going to get up there talking about they forgive this person before this person has even spent any time in jail. So, you know, it's refreshing to see some real people. And, you know, I just want to send my condolences to the family. I'm glad that the family has received some semblance of justice. You know, this killer will be locked away for 20 years, which is, you know, a far better sentence than what that Amber Geiger received in the Botham John case. So anyway, man, I had to follow up and, you know, mention this development in this case. Tell me what y'all think. Please rate, comment, subscribe, like the video, share the video, hit that notification bell so that you'll know when I post new content. Peace and blessings to each and every one.